A mortgage is a loan used for a piece of property. In this video, we are going to talk about some of the basics of a mortgage, including some of the terminology that is used when talking about mortgages. Purchasing a home is usually the largest single expense that people make, and it can be a very intimidating process. The reason that homes are bought with a mortgage is because very few people have the cash to buy a home outright. There are lots of reasons people buy homes, and each home buyer will need to weigh the risks and rewards of home ownership. At the same time, the bank also needs to weigh the risks and rewards of allowing someone to borrow a large amount of money from them in order to buy the home. If someone has shown themselves to be irresponsible with money in the past, such as carrying large amounts of credit card debt and not being able to pay them off, the bank will think twice about loaning them money. Let's say you want to buy a home. You will want to pay attention to both the term and the interest rate. Recall that the term of a loan is the amount of time in which you are expected to pay it back. Home loans are typically done with 15 or 30-year terms, although it's possible to have other terms. The interest is how much the bank is charging you to borrow their money. We are going to focus on fixed-rate loans, which are loans where the interest rate does not change. You can get a lower interest rate for a shorter mortgage, but your monthly payments will be larger. Typically, you would not take out a loan for the cost of the entire home. Instead, you would have a certain amount of money that you would pay up front. This is called a down payment. Having a down payment reduces the size of the loan that you need to take and also helps to demonstrate that you are financially responsible. Conventionally, the recommended size of the down payment has been at least 20% of the value of the house. However, in recent decades, that number has dropped quite a bit in some perspectives. But low down payments are a risk to banks because owners are less financially invested. Just before the recession, people were purchasing homes with no money down, and that contributed to the collapse of the housing market. When the buyer does not have 20% to put down, the banks are at an increased financial risk. In order to help mitigate this, the buyer must pay an extra amount for private mortgage insurance, or PMI. This amount only applies to the part of the loan that is beyond 80% of the price of the home. The PMI helps to protect banks in the event that you are unable to pay your mortgage. In other words, if you have less than a 20% down payment, you will pay an extra fee on top of what you already pay for the mortgage. This is another reason to try to have a larger down payment. As you can see, there are many components that go into figuring out the cost of a home loan, and there are even more things that we haven't even discussed here. The good news is that you can get reasonably good estimates using free online calculators. One such calculator can be found at mortgagecalculator.org. At the time of making this video, this is how the website looks. On the left side, there are boxes where you will type in various values. After entering the data, you will click the Calculate button. This will then update the information on the right. There's a lot of information here, and it can feel overwhelming. But this calculator will tell you the following important pieces of information: the size of your monthly payment with PMI, how much PMI you'll pay per month and for how long, and the size of your monthly payment without PMI. Although there is other information available, these are the basic numbers you'll be looking at if you get a mortgage to buy a home. In class, we will look at ways to try to determine whether you can actually afford to buy a home, as well as finding ways to reduce your payments.